Hey folks, today I want to talk about small modulations everywhere. It's pretty simple concept. When you try to make interesting sounds, you have to modulate them. Sounds without modulation sound pretty static. So I give you an example. I add one polysynth here, and with the init sound, the polysynth sounds pretty static. Nothing happens, it's just one static sine or saw wave. And we try to make them interesting. So the first tip is to use a random modulator to modulate the pitch slightly, just a little bit. Maybe make it faster. And use this polyphony button here down below. So we have different modulations for each voice. So the second one is use the unison. So to create two voices and to tune them slightly. And of course we can modulate this too, slightly. And I use a different random modulator to have a different seat of randomization. When I use the same modulator here, everything is modulated the same way, with the same seat, with the same phase, basically. So I create a different random modulator for each thing I do. Okay, the second one is maybe add a delay. And we can also add a slight amount of randomization to the offset. Just a little bit. And we can add a reverb in front of the delay to diffuse the sound before the delay stage. And maybe add random modulator to the reverb time, also just a little bit. And we can add a modulator to the FM, oscillator FM. And sometimes I even modulate the cutoff just a little bit, so it's not too static. So that's the first chain, and to prove that it brings much to the sound when you add slight modulations, I duplicate this instrument here and I remove every modulation. So let's listen. So sounds much more interesting to my ears, at least. And yeah, everything keeps evolving in slight amounts, and it feels like more alive and organic to my ears. And of course, you have to find a sweet spot. You need to try out different amounts of modulation on each parameter, but the general direction is add slight amounts of modulations everywhere instead of one big modulations to one parameter. So another trick I want to show you is to make the sound wider, and we can add here another random modulation to the pan. And now the sound is panned on each voice to the left and to the right randomly, which gives a wider sound. You also have to experiment with the speed, of course, to find the sweet spot for your sound. And another trick to make the sound more wide is to use the blur device. And the blur device is just a delay with a very short amount of delay of 1 millisecond. And you can modulate this too. So use one random modulator to free. Use very short time. Use this and modulate everything. It's a bit of work, but you can save a preset, of course. You can also use, of course, a macro to change the speed of every modulator. I have to turn this one off. If you modulate it too fast, you produce a lot of artifacts, so keep it down. Yeah. Just do everything to make the sound interesting. Slight modulations everywhere, it's the trick. So, okay. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial. I hope it helps for your sound design. And yeah, leave me a like and a comment, and I see you in the next video. Bye.